doctors, and I hope our presentation today will help you in your profession also. I think we are waiting for the mic, but if my voice can reach all of you, then we don't need the mic. Is it okay?
If you arrange it.
Okay, I am Dr. Arvind Poswal, and when I passed my medical studies, I knew nothing about hair. I assumed it would be something in a similar position. Hair transplant karaya, sabne newspaper mein padha, lekin doctors ko pata hi nahi hair transplant kya hota hai. Isliye ye wala presentation. So in nature, hair does not grow in as one hair per place. In nature, hair grows in groupings of 1, 2 or 3 hair per place. Those are called follicular unit grafts. And the whole concept of modern hair transplant is based on follicular unit graft. Initially, then why? What is so special about hair which you are taking from another place and putting here that it will grow? The difference is in genetics. These hair are genetically different. The hair of the beard is different from the hair of the scalp, is different from the hair of the body. The hair which is in front of scalp is also genetically different from the hair in the back of scalp. Like here you see, we have taken out beard hair and abdomen hair of the same person. They are different, even to look at. Here we see the chest hair and scalp hair, they are different. The main idea is, now there are facts about hair. In an average person, they have 1 lakh hair follicles. These hair, they go through 3 phases. The growth phase, which is called anagen, the catagen phase, and the telogen phase. This is, so when you see a lot of hair shedding when you are taking bath, do not worry, you are not losing those hair. Those are the hair which have gone into the resting phase. After a few months, they will again start growing. Or some reasons like deficit of iron, radiation and chemotherapy, and autoimmune diseases. These all can cause hair loss. But the most important cause of hair loss, which is said to be there in 40% of male Indian population, is androgenic alopecia or common baldness. But in androgenic alopecia, there is a chemical process which induces the hair to fall. The genetically susceptible hair to fall, right? That is called THT. Males produce a hormone called testosterone. It has a byproduct called dihydrotestosterone. Dihydrotestosterone can, on genetically susceptible hair, cause damage to the hair, and it slowly, so that gradually the hair gets miniaturized and is lost. If the person is castrated in between, chemical castration or physical surgical castration, he will not lose any more hair. But that is too drastic a treatment for hair loss. So what they did is they gave finasteride. It's something which reduces dihydrotestosterone and is used for benign prostatic hypertrophy. So they were giving this medicine for benign prostatic hypertrophy, and they noticed that people started, as a side effect, people started seeing new hair growth. So you know how marketing people are? They said, well, let's sell it to people who are losing hair. So they came up with alopecia. But these are the approved medicines, minoxidil and finasteride. Minoxidil is to apply on the scalp twice a day. Finasteride is to eat once daily. You can find detailed information about them on the websites which are mentioned. Of classifying everything. So they classified hair loss also. And this Dr. Norbert classified hair loss into different stages. Stage 1 being no hair loss, to stage 7 being extreme hair loss. But even in stage 7, you will not lose a narrow rim of genetically prominent hair. What, as I told earlier, what is involved in hair transplant? What is involved is that we are going to take genetically prominent hair groups and transplant them into bald area. This is called the principle of donor dominance. In the principle of donor dominance, the transplanted hair will behave in the same way as it would have behaved in its donor location in terms of longevity also. So, if you transplant beard hair to scalp, it will not become soft like scalp hair. It will become, remain thick and maybe curly. This is the safe donor area. Never ever take hair roots. Hair roots are taken from outside the safe donor area. They too will be lost because they are not genetically permanent. So understanding the safe donor area is very important. Then we cut. I know, looks gruesome. Then we take out this strip and we stitch it close. Now, that strip which we have taken out, it contains the entire thickness of the scalp, including the root, the bulb and the subcutaneous fat. This is that strip. You can see individual grafts, follicular units in this strip. These are separated. First, this strip is cut into individual slivers, like this. Okay? Now you can see the follicular units again. Now these are cut under microscope into individual follicular units. And these follicular units are then stored in chilled Ringer's lactate before they are transplanted into the new location. So how are they transplanted? And another magnification, this tiny root is taken and is put into the head set. People ask me, okay, what holds that new hair root in its new location? This is what the strip area looks like after a couple of months when the healing is complete. It is covered by the patient's own hair. There will be a stitch scar, remember, if he shaves. So, jaise gajni mein tha, there will be a long strip scar. He'll have to say, I'm fan of Arvind Poswal or whatever. Or he can get hair grafted into the strip scar. But do not forget, if we go for FUHT, there will be a long scar at back. Person shaves, that will be visible. So, the solution for that was the fuse technique. But now, I was coming to the fuse technique, which was invented by our clinic. It's slightly different, much less invasive. People are afraid of itna joda skin katega, a strip of skin will be taken out, stitch hoga, stitch pain hoga, it will be painful also for a few days. So, what is the option? The other option is the minimally invasive fuse technique. So what do we call fuse technique? Instead of taking out the entire skin, we take out individual follicular unit grafts one by one. So what is left? It is a more tiresome thing, but what is left is tiny holes which are less than 1 millimeter technique. There is an additional benefit also. I have been telling you that we can take care from this area to put in the scalp, but अगर किसी का हेयर लॉस बहुत ज्यादा है ये तो दिस इज अ स्मॉल एरिया हाउ कैन यू फिल दैट एरिया दैट यू कैन डू बाय यूजिंग बॉडी हेयर एंड बियर्ड हेयर इफ द पर्सन हैज सफिशिएंट क्वांटिटी ऑफ हेयर ऑन हिज एरियाज लेकिन बट इन दीज एरियाज यू कैन नॉट टेक अ स्ट्रिप यू कैन नॉट टेक अ स्ट्रिप यहां से एंड देन लीव अ लॉन्ग स्कार सो दैट इज वेयर द फ्यूज प्रोसीजर ऑफर्स इन सेकंड एडवांटेज इफ वी नाउ cases we have 10,000, maybe even 15,000 grafts which can be used to cover an entire scalp if needed. Okay? So these are some benefits of the fusing technique. This of course is a result of fuse technique. This is another one. People who have extensive hair loss, they can use scalp, beard. This is the sort of hairline which we can now go for. सलमान खान से ज्यादा बढ़िया यस व्हाई दिस इज प्लेस सलाइन आल्सो और एनी अदर सूटेबल फ्लूइड रीजन इज वंस इट इज टेकन आउट द हेयर फॉलिकल इज टेकन आउट ऑफ द बॉडी इट नीड्स अ मीडियम इन व्हिच टू सर्वाइव अदरवाइज इट विल ड्राई ऑफ एंड इट विल डाई हेयर ट्रांसप्लांट प्रोसीजर टेक्स अबाउट 6 टू 8 आवर्स सो टिल दैट टाइम दैट दीस follicles are re-implanted into the body, they are stored in chilled saline or chilled sphingolactate at 4 degrees.